I'm Ranger Kim.
Hey y'all, I'm Ranger Stephanie.
Hi, I'm Ranger Pele.
Welcome to Crater Lake National Park's virtual Junior Ranger program. We are here on the rim of beautiful Crater Lake, and today we'll discover how Crater Lake came to be, how a mountain became a lake. As we tell this story, we'll be using our volcano model made of sand to demonstrate how Crater Lake formed. Here in Southern Oregon, many small volcanoes grew over hundreds of thousands of years. That would have looked something like these small mounds that I'm making here in the model. Eventually, they grew together to become one mountainous volcano, now called Mount Mazama. Some geologists think Mount Mazama might have been 12,000 feet tall. That's almost 10 times as tall as the Empire State Building.
Mount Mazama loomed tall for thousands of years. It was defined by times of peace and times of violent eruptions. It was adorned in glaciers that carved steep basins that can still be seen here at Crater Lake today. Approximately 7,700 years ago, Mount Mazama experienced a major change. Due to tectonic activity, Mount Mazama's magma chamber began to fill with molten materials and gases. This pressure caused expansion within the magma chamber, eventually bursting through the northern side of the volcano's summit. Ash shot 30 miles up into the atmosphere from this fracture. Geologists speculate that if you lived as far away as Nebraska, you would have heard the initial boom from the eruption. Pumice was ejected into the sky, falling back to the earth like rain. Molten material squeezed outward, smothering anything within its path. As this super colossal eruption continued, the magma chamber began to shrink, and the summit developed a circular fracture around its entire circumference. This eruption lasted around 2 to 3 weeks, and because so much material came out of the mountain, including ash, boulders, pumice, that the inside became somewhat hollow. So something pretty amazing happened.
Since the inside was hollow and the outside of the mountain had all those fractures, the sides of the mountain could not hold up the top anymore. And so the top of the mountain actually collapsed inward on itself, creating the caldera that Crater Lake is now in. Now, this here is going to represent our magma chamber that's underneath the mountain. As Ranger Stephanie explained, most of what was inside the magma chamber got ejected during the eruption, so where there was the hollow area underneath the mountain. Today, we are going to show you what the mountain might have looked like right before the eruption, including the plants and animals living on it. Remember, there were all those cracks on the side of the mountain, so the top of the mountain couldn't hold itself up anymore. So the top of the mountain actually collapsed inward on itself, which would have looked something like this. Wow, isn't that amazing? After that collapse, Mount Mazama would have just looked like a huge smoking pit. But that's not what it looks like now, right? Well, over the next few hundred years, that pit filled with rain and snow to create the beautiful lake that we see here today. It looks so peaceful out there, doesn't it? Do you think this peaceful mountain will erupt again, or do you think the volcano is extinct? Well, Mount Mazama is actually not extinct. In fact, it has had eruptions since that super colossal eruption 7,700 years ago. There were smaller eruptions that formed features like Wizard Island, the extinct cinder cone that you see up rising above Crater Lake's surface. And there are even more small lava domes and other volcanic features underneath the surface of the water that we can't see.
This pumice formed during the pressurized eruption and contains airspace resulting in its light weight. Do you think that this rock will float? They both float. Now, if we put this iron-rich rock from Wizard Island in the dish, do you think it'll float? It sinks. As you can see, every single rock has a story. These rocks tell the story of Mount Mazama's history.
And now you can tell this story too. Share what you've learned with a friend or family member and try making your own Mount Mazama at home. You can make your volcano out of sand, dirt, clay, or anything else you can think of. If you have a balloon at home, you can even make your own caldera. Thanks for joining us for our first virtual Junior Ranger activity. We'll see you next time.